In the Constitution, the single most important issue is Indigenous recognition. It's something that we've put in a lot of work into here at the law school. Some years ago, I established a constitutional reform unit, which has an aim of putting out to the public the sorts of information that you need to be able to understand proposals for constitutional reform and to be able to vote freely and fairly on them. And now what we're doing is a lot of work on the proposed referendum on Indigenous constitutional recognition, and that's happening at a number of fronts. So we're helping the parliamentary committee, which is looking at the words that might be used in a referendum, and also helping advise governments, politicians, interacting with community groups and with Aboriginal groups in order to try and achieve some kind of consensus as to what the most, the best form of constitutional reform will be, with a view to be able to put up the best proposal to the Australian people and to be able to explain it to them so that they can vote fully and fairly with knowledge and with confidence that they understand what they're doing. Well, in terms of the Constitution, if I had one thing I could change in it, I think it would be changing the mechanism for change. Because one of the problems that we've got is that our Constitution does tend to end up frozen because we very rarely have referenda, and when we do, they usually fail. And as a consequence of that, most constitutional change comes through the court, through the High Court, in reinterpreting the Constitution. That's all well and good, but it's not the most democratic way of doing things. It would be much better if we could let the Australian people make those choices and those changes. But one of the real problems we have is that the mechanism for making change is that it's only the Commonwealth Parliament that ever gets to put those changes to the Australian people. So what would be good is if we could open it up in a way that allowed the states, that allowed people, that allowed other groups to be able to put forward proposals for constitutional change and to have some kind of a mechanism so that on a regular basis proposals are put to the Australian people and that they can vote upon them. In terms of the upcoming changes, issues in constitutional law, the biggest ones at the moment are how we deal with Indigenous recognition and reconciliation. That's obvious, and I've spoken about that. I think the longer term one is going to be the issue of a republic, which will come back. People keep saying, well, we don't want to deal with it now, we'll deal with it when the Queen dies. But the problem is, if the Queen dies and we don't have a plan and we don't know what we're going to do, that's not going to be very useful. So I think one of the things that we need to start preparing for is, doing the hard work in terms of looking at our constitutional system and saying, well, we don't have to change it immediately, but if and when we get to the point where we decide we do want to change, what is it that we'd want to change to? So from a constitutional law point of view, I think that's, in a longer term, the sorts of things that we should be looking at now.